Are Why are you getting scared? Yupsi, say hi to them. Say hi. Hey dreamers, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. Hi, my name is Yusra. If you're new, if you're still not part of the family, we welcome everyone. Do me a huge favor, subscribe to my channel and also do click that bell button so you do not miss out on my future videos. In today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys my updated everyday makeup routine. This is the makeup routine which I have been doing lately, and this makeup does not required foundations. I'm not a foundation, not even a BB cream, only some few right products and you are good to go. My makeup is kind of slotted into three categories. One, the makeup that I do on a daily basis when I go to university or whatever, and the second makeup I do when I'm filming, when I do the filming, and the third one is a bit of glam look if I have to go to somewhere really important. So that will be the makeup look I'll be reaching out to. You must be thinking that you do not use foundation because you have a perfect skin. No, I don't have a perfect skin. To be honest, I do not take care of my skin that much, and I'm sure so many of you girls do not do that as well. We do not have a perfect skin. I am like you guys. Just because I use some moisturizer does not mean I have a perfect skin. Yes, moisturizing a face is important, which I do not skip. I moisturize my face on a daily basis, which is super important, and you should do that as well. If you do not moisturize, start moisturizing your face. I did my first makeup routine when I started this channel. I'm going to link in the description box if you guys are interested. I noticed that I talk a lot. Without any more rambling, let's just get into the video. So hot, this was solid in consistency and now it has been melted, converted into liquid. The first thing that is really important in my daily makeup routine is moisturizing. I use this Shea Miracle. It's an oily consistency, so I avoid using it in the morning. Instead of that, in the morning I use this aloe vera gel. Aloe vera gel is really light and hydrating. It smells so good. It's also good for all the skin problems. It heals acne. I'm gonna wait for 5 minutes for the moisturizer to do its job. The primer I'm gonna be using is the Rimmel London Lasting Finish Primer. What it says actually, it increases the foundation wear up to 8 hours. And to be honest, I do not trust on primers unless they are really good, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. If you do not apply primers, then skip it. I'm gonna apply the primer onto my problematic areas, that is my cheeks and my chin and maybe a bit on my forehead. Just blend it in with your fingers. Do not rub. We do not want to remove product. We just want it to set there and sunk into our skin. Primer is done. And again, we are going to wait for a few minutes for our primers to do its job. Make sure guys, you give 5 minutes each to everything, like moisturizing and primer, so they do their job. Let them do what they are meant to do. So 5 minutes is good to go. While this thing is doing its work, I'll do my brows. And for my brows, actually anything could work out for my brows. It's giving me good brows. I'm up for it. I do not care about the high-end products or the local products. I just want a good product for my eyebrows. I kind of switch from pomades to pencil, sometimes powder, but these days I'm using the pencil. It is from Kiss Beauty, a brow precise shaping pencil. If you have lighter hair, you have to use 2 or 3 shades darker, and if you have darker hair, you have to use 3-2 shades lighter brow product. For everyday natural eyebrows, you have to keep your eyebrows as much natural as you can. Do not go for those Instagram eyebrows. Keep it natural, keep it simple. Brows are not scissors. I also have those days when my eyebrows do not even match. Here I have quite a good arch, but here I do not have any arch, and thanks to the powder wali auntie. Do not make them identical. There's no such thing as identical eyebrows. Make it good, make it almost same, maybe sisters. in my eyebrows, I just take my spoolie and brush through it. Using this Clinique concealer, which I use in my every video, this Pond's BB, Pond's White Beauty BB Cream. I'm gonna be mixing these two both and gonna use this as a concealer. I have my concealer right here, and now what I'm gonna do, I have some concealer on my brush, and let's just conceal the eyebrows and make them precise. For my eyebrows, I use my fingers. If you use beauty blender, then use whatever you want, whatever you are suitable with. Just use your favorite tool. So whatever concealer was left on my hand, I'm gonna use this concealer to conceal my under eye bags. I'm gonna take this concealer a bit down to conceal my problematic areas. That is my scars. I'm having a bit of scar, and also I will apply a bit onto my chin. And everything with a beauty blender or a brush, whatever you prefer. Once we are done with the concealer, we have to set it with the powder. I'm gonna be doing a baking method for this. It is going to set and lock everything. It is going to make sure that the concealer will not move. If you do this method correctly, you are going to love this technique. I'm also going to dust off the excess banana powder. This is set those areas where I haven't applied this powder, this amount onto my brush, and apply onto the areas where I haven't applied the powder before. Well, you can skip the blush and even the highlighter part, which I'll show you in a bit. You can skip these all parts, but if you want, then you can go for it. But make sure you apply the tiniest amount so your makeup look as more natural as possible. Apply is from MAC Love Thing. It is in a reddish type of, you know, it has a bit of shimmers to it. I'm gonna take this much onto my brush, but keep one thing in your mind. Since it's a glittery blush, the sun is going to all the glitter that you have applied onto your face. It is going to enhance all the problematic areas. If you have pores onto these areas, it is going to show up. Do not apply the glittery blush. Go for the more matte blush, but if you're okay with it, go with it. As for my highlighter, the reason why I like this face contour kit, especially it's a highlighter, really, really naturally in the morning, you do not want to apply so much highlighter so you end up looking like a disco ball. You do not want to look like a disco ball in the morning. So this highlighter is really, really natural. I love this highlighter, and this is a highlighter what I personally use, and sometimes I apply this onto, you know, special events as well. I'm just going to, you know, mix these two, then I'll apply it directly. You see that? It looks so natural and so nice. Oh wow. I love this highlighter. I'm gonna apply a bit onto my cupid's bow and a tiny bit onto my chin and maybe on my forehead as well. I love highlighter, and this palette, I love this palette a lot. I go for more bold lips. If you do not like bold lips, if you like nude lips, you do you, boo boo. Lipsticks that I apply are these Clazona lipsticks. Enjoyed this video. If you did, please give this video a big fat thumbs up. I'm gonna see you guys in my next video. Allah Hafiz, Pia Manila.